Hi, my name is Trisha Blosser, and I work in development at Eastern Mennonite School. I'm also an alum of the school. I graduated in 1995, and as we look to what would have been our homecoming reunions coming up, the homecoming looks a little bit different this year. I had a chance to connect with some of my classmates, so I wanted to bring them together in a chapel just to hear about what their experiences were like here and where they've been and get some of their thoughts on our chapel theme. So right now I have with me Heather and Elizabeth, and I'll have them introduce themselves. I'll also be talking with Obi and Jordan. He's in a different time zone, so I'll be adding him in and his comments as we go. But right now it's just me and Heather and Elizabeth. So Heather, do you want to start and introduce yourself and just tell us what you're up to these days?
Right. My name is Heather Ruark, also a 1995 graduate of, at that time, EMHS, of EMS. And right now I'm actually surprisingly in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. I never thought I'd end up in another Mennonite area of the world. Moved here 2 years ago after spending 13 years in Mexico. So after 13 years teaching in Mexico, now I'm teaching in a Spanish immersion program that Lancaster Mennonite has at the elementary level.
My name's Elizabeth Swager-Butella, another 95 graduate. And I'm currently living in North Carolina in Apex, which is right around that triangle area. I stayed in their area after going to UNC Chapel Hill, for grad school. And I'm a scientist. I work testing pharmaceuticals for safety profiles at a company called Bioagilytics here in the area. And I have one son, two dogs, a cat, And that's kind of what I'm up to these days.
So yeah, I'm calling in from Jordan. I've been living in Jordan for the past 3.5 years with my family, my wife Carrie, and two sons, Theodore, who's 10, and Cyrus, who's 8. We came here for work originally. Both my wife and myself work for international nonprofits. I work for an organization called FHI 360, originally Family Health International.
Okay, well, thank you for introducing yourselves. One question I wanted to ask you is if you have a memory of your time when you were here at EMHS that you would like to share with our students and with our school community today.
One memory that came up recently, even before this chapel idea came about, was I have two sons. One son's in seventh grade and just started junior high soccer. So I didn't play soccer. They didn't even have girls soccer then. But I played volleyball and basketball throughout high school. And so, you know, yesterday seeing him get on the bus and go far away, like an hour away, as a mom, really kind of letting go. You're like, wait a second, this was one of my absolute best memories of EMS, was, you know, getting on the bus with the volleyball team, getting on the bus with the basketball team, being out late, getting back exhausted, trying to do your homework. But now that time is gone and you see your son doing, you're like, wow, that was the most amazing part of high school, was the sports. And maybe that goes along with the theme of belonging, like really belonging in the sense of belonging with your team.
So it's funny that you're talking about the sports team's memories, because that's definitely one of the first things that I was thinking about. I played basketball badly, but I still felt, you know, part of the team. But no, I remember actually Mr. Mumal's science room with all of the taxidermied animals up on the wall. And I'd always just love being in that room. The other thing I remember was the cafeteria ladies made the most amazing peanut butter cookies. And this cake, the white cake with the jello kind of swirled in, I think it's called poke cake. I still think about those things. So yeah, food and stuffed animals, that's the main
thing. That'd be good, I guess, good fortune to be part of the touring choir, both my junior and senior year at EMS. And so yeah, definitely look back very fondly on that experience, both just being part of the choir, meeting many of my classmates and either the year ahead of me or behind me. that I wouldn't have gotten to know otherwise. And then, you know, of course, we each year we did a bus trip together to communities around the U.S. and Canada in some cases. Just a very enriching experience.
So my next question for you is just on our theme of belonging. Our vision here at the school is to be a learning community where every student belongs, thrives, and lives God's call. So would love to hear from you if there are times you felt you've belonged in a place or times you haven't felt and what that looked like for you. And Heather, I guess you can go first again, and then Elizabeth, feel free to jump in when she's finished.
When I was thinking about, I really like thinking about the theme of belonging. I guess the first part of belonging I thought of in relation to EMS was I came into, like several of us, came into EMS in seventh grade as like a non-ethnic Mennonite. I don't know if people still say that. Ruark is my last name, and my parents sent me there because it was a good academically strong school, and that's about all I knew. And I remember even going in, I went into a basketball game, I think a guy's varsity game, and I had in seventh grade, my Navy, U.S. Navy sweatshirt on. I was like, yeah, my cousin's in the Navy. And then people were just looking at me and like, what? And I remember other days going to meet people's grandparents, like, what's your last name? And they were very nice, like very nice grandparents. I'd be like, Ruark. And they're like, oh, that's not Mennonite, is it? And it was that feeling of like, I don't fit here. Like, I look like people here, you know, it wasn't a race thing. It wasn't something like that. Like, I know a lot of people deal with, but like, I don't fit with this last name or with this. I didn't know what MYF was. Like, people are talking about MYF. What in the world is MYF? As the years went by, that completely changed. And it was part of like joining in sports and joining in clubs and making friends. And I think that shift happened. Didn't take too long, but that was an immediately hard thing to do. And middle school is hard as it is. So my sons are De La Rosa because my husband's from Mexico. And so, you know, they're at Lancaster Mennonite. And I'm assuming the same thing at EMS now, where it's not weird to have a De La Rosa or a Rodriguez or Martinez in your school anymore. And it's part of the community, and the Hispanic population is so important. Another thing, and I hope this isn't too long, is that, you know, I moved to Mexico with my husband because he missed his family a lot, and he had some immigration issues to work out. And I immediately was kind of worried. I was like, you know, I spoke Spanish already, but I was like, well, I'm moving to another country. I'm going to be the outsider, you know, being from another country, not speaking Spanish as a native. But I think there, I shouldn't have been surprised, but people were so welcoming. There was this, unfortunately, sometimes idea that, wow, United States, and I have a cousin there, or I want to go to Disney, or I want to go to New York. It's a very seen very positively. And so I feel like being an outsider in Mexico was always, I can basically say always, I know it's hard to say always, but always say it was a positive thing. And so when I came back, I think it shifted my focus on how can I help people who are immigrants to the United States belong when I think they're not being received the same way. And I can speak for my husband, you know, comments about my husband, like, oh, what's your background? In Costco the other day, they asked him if he was a citizen or not. And I was like, he was renewing his membership. And he's like, you don't need to ask me that question. And so I know it's that sense of belonging. Like, my role now is because I was received so well as an immigrant in Mexico. Can I do the same thing for immigrants here?
So I was thinking about this a lot, and I don't know that I have specific memories that I wanted to share, more so as just an overall thought about belonging. It's a topic that's really important, and it seems to be coming up a lot recently. And, you know, I've gone through life, and I think it's going to be true for people throughout life, is you have times where you feel like you belong, and you have times where you feel like you don't. And in high school, it was hard for me. It wasn't anything at the school. I didn't feel necessarily excluded or as an outsider or picked on. But I struggled, and I struggled with suicide attempts and eating disorder and feeling just not part in general. And I wanted to remember, I made a promise to myself that I would remember what that time in my life felt like when you're trying to figure out who you are and where you want to be in the world. And I think that desire that we have to belong somewhere and to be part of something is a God-given desire. I think, you know, it's a desire that pushes us ultimately to God, although those connections with other people are so important. I mean, the Bible says that it wasn't good for me to be alone. And I don't take that in just the sense of marriage. I think it's just, we need other people to be at our best. And the groups that you belong to and the people that are part of your community will change throughout your life. And I think that's one of the things that it's not always clear, is that you're not going to have one identity or one group that will define you your entire life. And I think when people try to base their identity on one group, what can happen is you get scared if anything challenges that identity or that group identity. And so people start to close off and become very protective of that identity, that group. And what happens is you start excluding people who don't exactly fit that or aren't exactly like you. And so what happens is, instead of finding your community, you become isolated with just a small group. And so I would just want to encourage people that find your group, find your people, your tribe, whatever you want to call it. Although that's, you know, slang sometimes isn't entirely sensitive, but the people that will be with you in this time in your life, but realize that your ultimate sense of identity and your belonging is always going to be found and rooted in God. And if you can find that constant there, then you can accept yourself, and then you can accept other people to help them feel like they belong too. So I hope that you have good friends, that if you're in a time right now where maybe you don't feel like you'll have good friends, that you'll find them, and that you can be a good friend to other people.
I guess there was one dimension where maybe I didn't always feel well, it was something that I guess was unique to my experience, and made that feeling of belonging maybe a bit more challenging for me. And that was the fact that, you know, during my elementary school years, my family had moved to San Jose, Costa Rica for 3 years from the Shenandoah Valley. And the rest of my life was in Harrisonburg and outside it. And that was, you know, a wonderful experience in many ways, but I think was very different as well. And I think as a young person, it was sometimes challenging to integrate, you know, that very different international experience I had with the reality, you know, that we were all living in Harrisonburg at the time. Looking then forward to what I'm doing today, I think some of those things that I did back at EMS, I'm still active in, as I mentioned, in choir, and I do play sports here in Jordan, and I think that international experience that I felt kind of challenging for me, I'd say, at that point in time, also I think did prepare me in many ways for what I'm doing now, which is I have, you know, over the course of my career been in multiple different countries, and I think that process of getting to know and engaging with another culture and society.
I want to thank Heather and Elizabeth and Obi for sharing with us with such vulnerability and openness. It's good to hear their reflections, where they're at today, and then their thoughts on our theme. For students, thank you so much for listening. I hope you enjoyed this, hearing from some alumni that walked some of these same halls and sat in some of these same classrooms as you think where your future might lead. So thank you so much. Hope you have a great day.